NBC News. When I go to work, this is often the kind of place, a roadblock in the West Bank. Sometimes it gets dangerous, but I always tell my mother, don't worry, because whenever I go to work, I wear a flak jacket and a helmet. And she says, Martin, if you have to wear a flak jacket and a helmet to go to work, you should get a new job. But I can't. I've always loved this job. It's something of a mission. I always wanted to write a book about it. You get the drama and the excitement on TV, but not the adventure, the fear, the strange joy of covering wars, revolutions, human dramas of all kinds, and all while trying to bring up a family. So many of the books by journalists are about the effects of new media or the decline of values. But I think the real thing is this is a disappearing way of life. Reporters who go out in the field and cover the world's trouble spots. It seems to me we're losing sight of what it's really all about. Real people and their real lives, oftentimes in ultimate stress. And also, of course, don't forget the sheer fun of it all, the challenges, the excitement, the danger. What a great life and job it's been. I wanted to share the stories and adventures to bring back some of the fun of the road. 35 years I've been chasing news, adventures, with a passion for finding the truth and a passion, let's face it, for having a good time along the way. But it's true, the best journeys end at home, and that's where I find myself now, looking back, drawing lessons about life, about lessons learned the hard way. And I wanted to share them, have fun writing about it. It's been hard, tough, sometimes terrifying, but also rewarding and packed with moments of fun and real friendship on the road, especially with my mate Jeff here behind the camera. Somalia, Kosovo, Bosnia, all over Africa, Iraq, Iran, the list is endless, 35 years. But each place brought up its own dilemmas, how to stay safe and fair while staying as close to the truth as and to the action as possible. Talking to warlords in Somalia, famine victims in Ethiopia, mass killers in Cambodia, terrified Muslims in Kosovo, Sarajevo under siege, the river of death in Rwanda. What a journey. What I love most about the job still today after 35 years is just talking to people, understanding their problems, letting them know that the world cares, and hopefully really making the world care. In short, being a storyteller of the truth. That's what I've always done on TV, and it translates, frankly, well into a book. Not concentrating on the news, but the stories behind the news, how it's done, the people who do it, the adventures along the way. It's a mission, but for me it didn't start out that way. This book, then, is about my growth from a clueless young adventurer who really just wanted to travel the world at somebody else's expense, preferably, to a, well, what, let's face it, a grizzled veteran of conflict. It's a wonder I've stayed sane enough to survive and long enough to write this book. Well, you can be the judge of how sane I am. It's all in the book.